अस्सलाम वालेकुम, दिस इज शाजिया आमिर मक्सी, लेक्चरर एट सिंध यूनिवर्सिटी कैंपस लाड़काना, द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस. टुडे वी लर्न अबाउट कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क्स, वीक 12, लेक्चर 1 एंड 2, यूजिंग टेलीफोन, हाई स्पीड डेटा एक्सेस एंड डेटा ट्रांसमिशन. फॉलोइंग आउटलाइन विल बी गोइंग टू कवर टेलीफोन नेटवर्क, मेजर कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ टेलीफोन नेटवर्क एंड LTEs, सर्विसेज प्रोवाइडेड बाय टेलीफोन नेटवर्क, हाई स्पीड डिजिटल एक्सेस. व्हाट इज टेलीफोन नेटवर्क? टेलीफोन नेटवर्क इज नेटवर्क यूज सर्किट स्विचिंग. द टेलीफोन नेटवर्क हैड इट्स बिगनिंग इन द लेट ऑफ 18th सेंचुरी एंड द एंटायर नेटवर्क व्हिच इज रिफर्ड एज टू बी पोर्ट्स प्लेन ओल्ड टेलीफोन सिस्टम. इट वॉज ओरिजिनली analog systems using analog signals to transmit device, but during last decade the telephone network has undergone some technical changes and network is now digital as well as analog. Here we have a figure which shows that there are few major components of the telephone network, that is local loop, trunks and of switching offices. To access the network, they uses telephone lines uses local access transport area for the transmission. Here we have shown that through telephone they are connected to tool offices, then it distributed over a network with switches, and each line is connected to the local loops and using trunks. Telephone services provided by the network are local call services, tool call services, wide area telephone services and digital data services. Because these services are based on analog signals and digital signals. Digital signals provide digital data, analog signal provide the continuous form of the data. So how the connection takes place? Using these services between these components, a telephone network works on the basis of their subscribers. So they uses to communicate using the local loops at the end offices or for the central connectivity. But after the advent of new technology, high speed digital data will be accessed by using these devices, digital subscriber line, cable modem and SONET. SONET means synchronous optical network. So these devices will be used for the high speed data access. They were diverted toward the new technology based devices for high speed connections. For example, the connection developed using data transmission like video conferencing and transmission of data like email and video displaying data on a YouTube without delay in between the frames. That is example of high speed data over a network. And the reason behind this technology is based on that previous system has some limitations, because previous system has weak internet connectivity, data transmit through the analog signals, so they has need some time to move the data. That is why they use digital system to for the data transmission. And in digital system we knew that data transmit through the specific type of packets for transmission, data transmission. That is why Data always in the form of frames without any delay in gap they transmit to from source to destination. Here we have few types of digital subscriber line. That digital subscriber line is a technology of one of the most promising for supporting high speed digital communication over existing local loop. Here we have few types of DSL, ADSL, ADSL Lite, HDSL, SDSL and VDSL. First of all, we will discuss what is ADSL. ADSL is a symmetric communication technology designed for residential users. It is not suitable for the business. It uses twisted pair cables to connectivity over a local loops, and it uses only 4 kilohertz data over a network. ADSL uses only 1.1 megahertz bandwidth for the data transmission. ADSL is also adaptive technology, and the system uses the data rate based on the conditions of local loop line. ADSL is not fixed. It may be changes according to time to time. Its version will be going to change and updated according to its data rate. ADSL Lite is a device. There no need any splitter, and it is based on always on condition over a digital communication network. ADSL Lite is also known as universal ADSL. Now, ADSL provides asymmetric communication, and downstream bitrate is much higher than upstream bitrate. Downstream means downloading and upstream means uploading. Although this feature means the needs of most residential subscriber, it is not suitable for business that send or receive the data on a large volume in both directions. So that is why they use another technology, that is high bitrate digital subscriber line. HDSL was designed as an alternative of this device that uses alternate mark inversion AMI encoding scheme for higher the frequencies and reduces the attenuation between the noise. Now SDSL, symmetric digital subscriber line, it is designed for business, purely business purpose, and it has high bandwidth rate as compared to the ADSL, but it has higher downstream rate but less upstream rate. VDSL means very high bitrate digital subscriber line. It is another approach of advance of DSL device. And that uses the coaxial cable and fiber optic cable, but it uses for only the short distances, and it uses a technique that is DMT for modulating and demodulating. It has data bit rate over a 50 to 55 megabits per second downstream, and 1.1 to 2.5 MB is upstream data rate. Then another type of device, that is SONET, synchronous optical network. It is a device which uses the high bandwidth of fiber optic cables, such as it uses for the data transmission, such as video conferencing, and in which no gap between the data during the transmission, and it uses STS, synchronous transport signal, as a multiplexer of a device for the data transmission. Mostly it is used on the private organization. Mostly it is used by a private organization. The conclusion and summary of this lesson is that using the telephone network and high speed data access control over data transmission over a network that uses a few devices, from the traditional technology to the modern age technology, they use the device digital subscriber line as compared to the old network, telephone network. Thank you very much. If you have any question, you can contact through this email address.